but you ain't looking at no other. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you fit. This is one of the most annoying songs of all time.
I came in like a wrecking ball. I never hit so hard in love.
That was Miley Cyrus's most popular song. But do you know her first ever released songs? Do you know other artists' first released songs? I don't, you don't. Let's check it out in this very interesting video. Okay, here we have Sam Smith. His first song was called Bad Day All Week. This song was released in 2008. It failed to make pretty much any impact on the chart, and the rest of the album was cancelled. So yeah, a little bit of a boo-hoo moment for Sam Smith there. He ended his association with Venus and Mars Music, who he was signed to. But anyway, let's listen to this not breakthrough song.
You take me over the hill to meet your ex-lover. You let me out of your box every other day.
Wait, what? This came out in... Wait, it sounds like 80s, but this came out in 2008. Like, the production's all weird. That's funny. I know this is gonna be an amazing video now. I don't think this song is super bad or anything, but it definitely doesn't fit his voice. And it's called Diva Boy. Here's a quote from Sam. It gave me the ability to learn my art. When that's the best thing you can say about something you made, you know you don't think that it's good yourself. Let's compare it to Sam's most popular song and see which one is the best. Sam Smith's most popular song is called Stay With Me, and following his success as a featured artist on Disclosure's Latch and Naughty Boy's La La La. Those were two huge featured spots for him on songs. Sam released his debut studio album In the Lonely Hour. I can't believe that Diva Boy wasn't his first album. So sad it didn't get released.
Oh, won't you stay with me? Cause you're all I need. This ain't love, it's clear to see. But darling,
it just goes to show that singers can sing pretty much any genre. Or like, I mean, he's singing on the other song isn't bad. It just doesn't play to his strength. Funny that like people kind of go through these different paths of figuring out what type of music they want to make. And then suddenly something hits. I mean, he could have been like the badly mixed 80s guy if the first stuff had worked out. People's first songs are bad. I mean, my first songs are bad too. So. But you'll never hear them. Actually, I might have already shown them in a video. Never mind. I'm going to go ahead and give the first points to Sam Smith's most popular song. Next up, we have Drake with his first song, Replacement Girl. This was released back in 2007 on Drake's own label. This song made Drake become the first ever unsigned Canadian rapper to have his music video featured on BET, Black Entertainment Television.
How to come a long way from a day's end, and other hotels that I stayed in. I took a lifestyle from mediocre to good, and now we're saying sitting at amazing. Girls trying to so whole lobby us, hear them all screaming, and it's probably us. This album for my fans, but yo, this hook is for my
this
ex.
This one is for you, girl, you know.
For a first song, that's not too bad, honestly. I thought that was pretty good. The hook was a little bit cheesy, though. Let's move on to Drake's most popular song, a little song I like to call One Dance. One Dance became Drake's first song to reach number one in Canada, US, and UK as a leading artist. That's crazy.
Grips on your waist, front way, back way, you know that I don't play.
This beat is so genius. It just has so much space. I don't know, it's just, I love it so much.
That's why I need a one dance. Got a Hennessy in my hand. One more time before I go. Higher powers taking a hold on me.
How catchy is that? Come on!
Come on! Drake, he did it!
Okay, so let's choose which song was the best. I'm gonna go ahead and give another point to the most popular song. It's almost like songs that get popular do so for a reason, and that people's first songs usually are not their best. Maybe we'll get surprised. Next up, we have Pharrell Williams' first song called Frontin'. After successfully producing songs for various artists during the 90s and early 2000s, Pharrell released his first solo single, Frontin', in 2003. This is interesting because since he has so much experience producing for other artists, I feel like this might actually be really good. That first phrase, that was straight up Ice JJ Fish.
It's something about the girl that just makes my head on. Don't wanna sound full of myself a room.
That is the same thing. Wow.
You do well. So then you
touched
you. Then we locked eyes.
I'm sorry, that's just, it sounds like someone joking. And it doesn't feel swaggy like a lot of other off-key singing. This just sounds like someone's like, and his most popular song, we got Pharrell Williams' Happy. Happy was co-written and performed by Pharrell for the 2013 movie Despicable Me 2. Very cool. The song became a huge international success and led to Williams being nominated for 7 Grammy Awards.
Bruh.
8 more Grammy Awards than I have.
Here come bad news, talking this and that.
Isn't it funny that this was written for an animated movie and then you had the kind of similar in vibe and kind of like concept of Justin Timberlake's Can't Stop the Feeling that was also for Trolls, an animated kids movie? This is how we get our hits now. Animated kids movies. This is one of the most annoying songs of all time, I gotta say.
Well, I should probably warn you, I'll be just fine.
He's on key now, at least. Like, he's singing, but also, like, the tone and everything. It's very different.
Here's why. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth.
I'm gonna go ahead and give this one. It goes unpopular as well. I don't know if anything's gonna change, honestly. Here we got John Mayer, first song called Back to You. The more well-known version of Back to You was released on the 2001 album Room for Squares. But before that, however, it was released as a demo on John Mayer's 1999 debut EP, Inside Once Out. Okay, it's a little bit pitchy. I may be a bit biased because I've heard the kind of like up-produced version of this where he sings a little bit better, but I think this song is really, really good, honestly. This is a really strong song. Lyrically, John Mayer was just great, great, great at lyrics very, very early on.
Yeah.
I get a little bit of goosebumps, even though it is like a little bit pitchy and poorly produced. His most popular song is called Waiting on the World to Change. Released in 2006, he won a Grammy for Best Pop Song with Vocal and Best Pop Album. Oh, I didn't know that.
Now we see everything that's going wrong with the world and those who lead it. We just feel like we don't have the means to rise above and beat it. So we keep waiting, waiting, waiting on the world to change.
Compared to Back to You, I feel like there's so many songs like this. I don't know, it's like one of those songs that tries to be a movement or like describe a movement. Also, this is when John Mayer started singing like a lot more higher and with more distortion.
Waiting on the world to change.
I'm not a huge fan of that. I am going to go ahead and give first song a point. John Mayer came an old man and started making old man music. Boo freaking it. People are gonna be mad about that. Okay, moving on. Miley Cyrus's first song, See You Again. After gaining international fame as the lead character in Hannah Montana, Miley released her first non-Hannah album in 2007, which spawned the single See You Again. The song was a commercial success and sold over 2 million copies. Okay, so this one will be good. Pretty standard Disney pop to me. Like, there was a lot of songs like that, I feel like. Okay, Miley Cyrus's most popular song, Wrecking Ball. Have you heard of it? In an attempt to distance herself from the Hannah Montana brand, Cyrus went more and more mature in her songs. What does that mean, guys? Ruining childhood moments. They took like a child star and like, oh yeah, you're gonna be clothesless.
I came in like a wreck.
Yep. Never gonna do a 9-tracking video ever. That is just an iconic song. I think it's pretty timeless too in its production. I'm gonna go ahead and give that to the popular column. And Sia's first song was called Don't Get Me Started. In the mid-90s, Sia started her career as a singer in the local acid jazz band, Crisp. Interesting. In 1997, Crisp disbanded and she released her debut solo album, Only C. Unlike her later albums, Only C was marketed under her full name, Sia Furler. Wow, scratching, cool.
Yeah.
She's inspired by those like 90s like grunge band, like Star Dare. What is his name? Yeah, Pearl Jam, that's it. It's so weird. In 2014, Sia broke through as a solo recording artist with her sixth studio album, 1000 Forms of Fear, debuted at number one on the US Billboard 200 and spawned the hit single Chandelier. Let's listen. Might be one of the most iconic vocal takes ever. That first, like, I don't think I can hit it properly. I can't do it. Gonna swag. Yeah, I can't do it. I'm gonna go ahead and give that to popular. Okay, next up is The Beatles. And we got their first song, P.S. I Love You.
I love you. You, you, you. As I write this letter.
I was expecting something like that, honestly. Sounded like something that pretty much any band in that time could have done. And here we have the Beatles' most popular song, Hey Jude. And here my researcher told me, there's just such an overwhelming amount of information about anything Beatles related, so you get none. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. This is what I pay you for.
Hey Jude, don't be afraid.
What a tune, though. Beautiful song. It's crazy to think about how popular they were, especially with the ladies. Looking at it now, we got these like super stylized, like BTS and stuff. And you're like, yeah, that's what girls. This is just like a random band that came together in Liverpool and just, they were the biggest thing. And all the girls were in love with them. Crazy. Anyway, I would say that Hey Jude wins this by a long shot. We are at 6-1. I can't believe the first songs aren't winning, guys. What's that you say? Building skills, getting better over time. Never heard of it. Okay, so here we have Katie Hudson. Nowadays known as Katy Perry. I know this before I read the research and she, ladies and gentlemen, was a Christian artist. Hudson completed the school requirements during her first year of high school and left to pursue a music career. Wow! And yeah, this song is called Faith Won't Fail. I mean, that has some interesting rhythm to it, and she sang really well here. She always goes really heavy in her modern pop stuff, like really, you know, up top, which leads her to sometimes have not the best live performances. She sounds great sometimes, and sometimes she doesn't. But like here, that sounded really controlled. There's the makings of Katy Perry's like iconic pop voice here, but it sounds a little bit more technically proficient almost. Weird. I do like that. Okay, so now for Katy Perry's most popular song. Katy changed her name to Katy Perry. She achieved international success with I Kissed a Girl, Hot and Cold, 2007, but her biggest song to date is Firework.
Baby, you're a fan.
Nice. Nice inspirational song. Definitely better than Faith Won't Fail. We're gonna give that one to popular as well. 7-1. Wow. Okay, next up we have Ariana Grande with her first song, Put Your Hearts Up. Grande first gained recognition as Cat Valentine on the Nickelodeon show Victorious. After the first season wrapped, Ariana wanted to focus more on her music, and 2011 her debut single, Put Your Hearts Up, was released. Wow, okay, what is that from? I'm just searching, hey, yeah, 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 what's going on? And I just get the meme. Another thing that sounds exactly like Pharrell's first single. Everything is going full circle in this video. Yeah, it's a sample or like an interpolation of What's Up by Four Non Blondes. In an interview with Rolling Stone in 2014, Grande said that Put Your Hearts Up was geared towards kids and felt so inauthentic and fake. That was the worst moment of my life. For the video, they gave me a bad spray tan and put me in a princess dress and had me frolic around the streets. The whole thing was straight out of hell. I still have nightmares about it, and I made them hide it on my Vivo page. And now we got Ariana Grande's most famous song. It's called Seven Rings, which is ironic because you only have five fingers on each hand. How are you gonna fit seven? Oh, you can put multiple rings on. Never mind.
Breakfast at Tiffany's and bottles of bubbles. Girls with tattoos who like getting in trouble. Lashes and diamonds, ATM machines. Buy myself all of my favorite things.
Oh yeah, and this is also a sample. I just realized. Sorry, interpolated, I guess.
Brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things.
Let's go back to the popified version.
You like my hair? Gee, thanks. Just got it. I see it. I like it. I want it.
What a love letter to capitalism. Anyway, it is objectively a lot better than her first song. Even though both of them are very heavily just taking melodies from other songs. Okay, guys, click here for more VS videos. Click here for other music commentary videos. And here's the final score. Big, big surprise. Popular songs won 8-1. Beautiful. I will see you tomorrow in another daily video. I appreciate you. Bye.